There's one man who's stealing all the headlines right now in Warsaw, Poland, and it's none other than 52-year-old Vishwanathan Anand. So he's a man who needs no introduction, former world champion, living legend. Now he's not a regular player these days, but he does dabble here and there, and he's playing in this Superbet Rapid and Blitz tournament. So we just had the classical tournament in Bucharest, Romania. That was the slow play one. Now the guys have gone over to Warsaw, Poland. So there's a lot of the same players that were playing in the last one. No Alireza Firuzja in this one. I love to follow his games. But we still have a great field and a few new wild card entries. Vishy Anand is one of them. So in his round one game, he was playing against Radoslav Wojtaszek. He won a lovely game there with a Roy Lopez. Now that guy is just coming off the back of winning the Polish championship, so he's in good form. You know, Vishy just turns up, kills the guy. Now in round two, he's playing against Wesley So. That's the game I want to cover in this video. And then in round three, he's playing against Anton Korobov. I'll give an update on that game at the end of this video, but let's first look at this game that he played against Wesley So. So Wesley went pawn d4 here. Anand went knight f6, pawn c4, pawn e6, and after knight c3, we go down this bishop b4 line, the Nimzo Indian defence. And now Wesley plays this really popular line right now, pawn e3. We've seen him do this against Shakhriyar Mamedyarov. He had a game of this against Sam Sevian in the American Cup, so he really knows this position well. Now we had castles from Vishy, bishop to d3 here, pawn d5, and after captures on d5, pawn recaptures, we get this a3 move, and Vishy just drops that bishop back. Now that he's castled, he's saving the bishop pair, and it's a very topical position, like said. Alireza Firuzja, for example, won a beautiful game from here against Lenia Dominguez in the tournament just gone. I'll link that at the end in case you missed it. So now we had queen c2, pawn c6, and this knight now comes to e2. And this is the really topical modern way to play. The knight's more flexible on e2, not on f3. There's a lot of themes here of the queen's gambit declined, Carlsbad structure, and that's the kind of stuff why it's going for, where you set up a pawn on f3, and then often you're playing for e4. So the knight now came to d7 by Vishy, standard development. And now here Wesley goes bishop to d2. In those Carlsbad structures I mentioned, by the way, that bishop's outside the pawn chain. So this is one of the subtle differences, but when white gets this stuff in, then the bishop will be liberated. And by playing like this, we can already see that white might go queenside in future for castling. So rook e8 from Vishy, very logical. Pawn f3, prepares e4 later. Knight f8, a nice looking move, prepares to come to e6 later, also covers h7, and the kind of safe move here for white is to castle kingside, play for e4. But Wesley goes queenside, he wants a real fight here, and now Anand goes for it, he plays pawn b5. And this is risky stuff by Wesley, because when you've already played pawn a3 here, we can see this one's now got something to bite on, it's a ready-made attack for black. So pawn e4 now played by Wesley, pawn b4 from Vishy. So it forces a capture here, the knight's about to be taken, the bishop now recaptures, and yes, you've made some incursions on the queen side, but now white gets pawn to e5. It kicks this knight back, and we can see that white's got the better pawn structure in the center. You know, if the king was on g1 here, this would be a great position for white. But because the king's on c1, it's a very different story. Black's now going to attack. Can white survive, use the better pawn structure long term? So after the knight dropped back, here Wesley should really look at playing pawn f4. You know, get his play going on the king side, attack Vishy, but he goes knight to a4 here. Now, of course, there's some points to this move. He opens up the queen here, attacks this pawn, although that's a very risky pawn to take. Also, the knight looks at some important squares. But after rook to b8 from Vishy, coming to that half-open file, defending his bishop, I really don't love the way Wesley plays. Now, it's the top engine move here. He takes on c6, but how risky does that look? Opening the line to your king here, down the c file, plus the B file's already half open. You have to tread so carefully now as white, and this is rapid play chess. So the bishop now took on D2, Vishy just clears that B file, the rook recaptured, and now he wants to get that bishop to A6, trade those ones off, open up his heavy pieces, but he can't yet do it, the square is covered. So he starts with bishop B7, the queen comes to D6, still holding that A6 square, but now the rook lifts into the game, beautiful maneuver, kicks the queen back, and now bishop A6 is achieved. And here Wesley makes a strategic blunder. So he should go knight to F4, he attacks the rook, attacks the weak pawn, rook C6 check is the best move, blocking with the white rook is best, but now white's actually getting some play, you're attacking that central pawn. The problem with what Wesley does instead in the game, he drops this bishop back to C2, but now he allows Vishy to chop this knight on E2. And the big problem with this, the reason that Vishy gives bishop for knight, is that it's now really hard for white to actually generate play against black, and we'll see that in a moment, because after rook A6, pinning that knight, threatening knight B6, the queen slid across to D3 here, it hits the rook, also threatens to check down here if the knight ever moved, but this highlights the problem now for white when you look at this position. So white's going to really struggle to actually drum up play. I mean, say you start pushing the h-pawn, well, where's that actually going? Are you going to go f4, then lift your rooks into the game? All of the white plans are very, very slow. In the meantime, black can play moves like queen a5, which is what Wesley did. It holds his rook, pressures the knight here, and the black attack is just coming so much faster than any of white's plans. So big trouble now for Wesley, and he recognizes this. He can see that Anand, for example, is going to go pawn g6 soon to cut this attack, and then he'll sit this knight on e6 here, where it pressures d4, threatens to hop into f4. So that's why this pawn e6 move was played. It stops the knight from occupying that really strong blockading square, forces black to capture that pawn, and now the knight can't come there. Now Wesley doubled on the e-file. This rook came to c6, there's now a threat to take that knight on a4 with the queen, the bishop is pinned, and the best way to protect against that is actually go pawn to b3, you give your king a bit of breathing room, now the knight still stands in an advanced position, although it is an ugly move, but after knight c3 here, now Vishy is just crashing through, so he could go rook b4 to lift that one into the game. He instead checks here, still an excellent move. The king comes to d2 and he simply picks up a pawn. So he's a pawn ahead here and it's a dangerous outside passer. That's going to be very good in lots of endgames. So the rook came to b1 here. It kicked the queen away. Yes, Wesley gets a pair off. The knight recaptures, but it's still so hard for him to drum up play. So he tries this f4 move, but now Vishy goes knight to a6. And Wesley's time is low, he has about 3 minutes, Vishy still has about 10, and here actually Wesley is so fed up with his position, he resigns the game, huge respect for Anand. Now why does he resign? Well, it's a bit premature, but knight b4 is coming, it's not easy to stop against. Say you go knight a4 for example, opening up these queens, well the queen could just drop back, knight b4 remains a threat. Say you go queen e3 to also cover this pawn, well now we can come back and check the king. If it runs away, well we could chop here on c2, pick up the knight with the queen, and you've got those two minors for the rook. This should be a one end game. There's many different lines here, but they're all terrible for white basically. So Vishy's on a roll, he was 2 out of 2 after this game, and who knows if he'll beat Korobov. He's looking good in that game, he could end up 3 out of 3 on day 1. What a player, what a legend. If you enjoyed this video, then do consider subscribing to never miss a future one, and see my amazing Alireza game against Lenia Dominguez, click here. Thanks very much for watching, see you soon.